unboxing the cervical mold. Once you open the box of the cervical mold, you will immediately find a quick guide. In this guide, you will be able to find quick information about the use of the system. However, we recommend that you take a close look on the instructions of use available into the site at www.innovatoholdings.com. You will be able to also to find the prosthetic connection database card. This card is particularly important as you can write down the type of VPI prosthetic connection insert utilized in every different position of the mold. And this can be used as a reference from your assistant when fabricating the custom healing abutments and their duplicate impression posts. In the box, you will find the cervical mold and the cervical driver. The silicone insert of the cervical mold comprises anatomically shaped welds, cylindrically shaped welds, and a duplication well. The anatomically shaped welds are divided in four groups. The first group refers to the shape and size of root rank of anterior teeth, small, medium, and large. The second group refers to the root rank shape and sizes of premolars, small, medium, and large. The third group refers to the shape and sizes of the root rank of square-shaped molars, small, medium, and large. And the fourth group refers to the shape and sizes of the root rank of elongated molars, small, medium, and large. The cylindrical welds can produce cylindrically in shape custom healing abutments and its duplicate impression posts, while the anatomically shaped welds produce anatomically shaped custom healing abutments and their duplicate impression posts. The duplication well can be used in order to duplicate a custom healing abutment where its subgingival portion has been modified intraorally, or also to duplicate the submerged area of a temporary prosthesis to a duplicate impression post. The cervical mold is available with the center silicone insert. This silicone insert produces custom healing abutments and duplicate impression posts where their body is centered to their core. You can uninstall the silicone insert by utilizing the cervical driver. Basically, flip the mold upside down and pass the screwdriver through one of the open holes. You push the silicone and then you pull it out. If you look at the base of the mold, you will see 36 open sockets. These sockets receive the VPI prosthetic connection inserts. Sockets number 1 to 14, not underlined, receive the VPI prosthetic connection insert flush to their top level. This is particularly useful if your clinical protocol involves crestal implant placement. Sockets number 15 to 28 can receive the VPI prosthetic connection insert, the last being 1 millimeter sunk into the sockets. This is particularly useful if your clinical protocol involves 1 millimeter subcrestal implant placement. Sockets number 29 to 33 can receive the VPI prosthetic connection insert, the last being sunk 2 millimeters into the socket. And this is useful if your implant protocol placement involves 2 millimeter subcrestal placement. Sockets 34 to 36 will receive the VPI prosthetic connection insert, being 3 millimeters sunk into the socket. This is useful if your implant placement protocol involves 3 millimeter subcrestal placement. Now you can take the silicone insert and you align the duplication well with the socket that resembles the duplication well on the top ring of the mold. Once the two wells are properly aligned, you just simply push the silicone insert into the base of the mold.
The VPI prosthetic connection inserts are integral part of the base of the mold. So once you place your order, you will have to specify what kind of surgical protocol do you use. Once the company installs the insert into the base, it will fill in the prosthetic connection database card for you, so that you are aware of the position that the insert has been installed, along with information with regards to that insert that concern the name of the implant company, the implant name, and the platform size. Finally, the VPI insert item number will be fill in the same card, so in case the VPI insert needs in the future to be replaced for any reason, you have the item number that you need to order for this replacement to take place. Thank you for watching.